you've listened to what I have to say. Now we can get back to the matter at hand.
Thank you. So spell out the deal again. We want to know for sure how this is going to change how we work the casinos and the clubs in Atlantic City and New York.
Well, as I said, if you want to continue gambling legitimately, then we'll bankroll you.
You're saying the family's going to put up the scratch, right?
That's right, yeah.
Tell us again, what are you going to do?
We will finance you at the rates we've already discussed, up until the cutoff date that's been set.
Where's this all leading?
Leading to no more criminal activity. No more gambling in illegal places. That's out. That's finished.
And again, if we don't want to gamble, how's that work?
As I've said, if you want out completely, we'll take care of you. We'll set you up in businesses of your choice, legitimate businesses of your choice.
What else?
We'll find new homes. We'll support your wives and your children. That is, of course, up until your new businesses start to show a profit.
Sounds okay.
It is okay, believe me. But once your businesses do start to show profit, well, then you repay us, of course, at regular bank rates.
We gotta think about it.
Okay. Take all the time you need. I'll be outside. Excuse me.
What do you think?
I don't know. Could go either way.
I was listening. You made a strong presentation.
I tried very hard.
Julian would have been proud of you.
Yeah, well, you know, we mustn't set our sights too high.
You loved it, didn't you?
What do you mean?
Being in there with them, knowing the kind of men they are, what you're trying to do. It's dangerous, but you loved it.
I don't know what you're talking about.
I think you do. It's in your blood. It's in mine. We both like living on the edge.
Oh, come on. The family, man. I hope they realize that there is a better way of life for themselves, for the wives, for the children. I hope they do.
It'll work out. It has to.
Yeah.
Duke?
Here we go.
I've got my fingers crossed.
Duke. We talked it over. Speaking for all of us, I can say we like what we hear, but we need a little more time to think about it. And you're right. The killings and stuff, they gotta stop.
Believe me, this is the way to a better life.
We'll be in touch.
Thank you.
Bring my bathing trunks with me.
Look, you can moan all you like, but something may have come from this.
Yeah, well, the only place we missed was the bottom of the harbor.
Coffee, thank you, Trixie.
Admit it, Robert. It was a wild goose chase.
All right. I admit it.
The thing is, you gotta remember that all the divers, all the police, everybody went over that area of the dock with a fine tooth comb.
Let's not forget one thing, and that is that shoe didn't turn up until the second time round.
Yeah, well, that was a fluke.
Well, when you're thorough, there are no flukes.
Here you go. You guys look like you could use something to warm you up.
Boy, that wind is blowing out there.
I know. And it's the kind that goes right through to the bone, even when it isn't really that cold.
Yeah. Thanks, Trace.
My pleasure.
You know, there is one thing that bothers me.
If it has anything to do with going back out there, then I don't even want to know.
All the items that were found were in the general proximity of Lavery's club.
Yeah. Yeah, but they were found just as close to Duke's club as it is to where we're sitting right now.
Speaking of Duke, look who's coming in.
Recently.
Too bad you didn't bring the shoe with you, Commissioner.
Huh? Yeah, you're right, Sam.
Let's go, sir. There's a friend of yours over there.
He's no friend of mine.
No, have fun anyway.
Thank you. Come on. Come on, I'm not gonna bite you. Here.
Very big of you to join me.
But you'd exhaust yourself with all that waving.
Come on, find me irresistible.
You're right.
I guess, come on, hang around.
What do you want, Mr. Scorpio?
I figure you might get sloppy and I can stick you with a check.
You're really shoveling it today, aren't you?
I'm just a poor working class stiff who craves your attention.
Oh, please.
So, what's new?
Nothing much. What's new with you?
Much the same.
Thrilling.
See Mrs. Woods lately?
You found any bodies in the river?
Got any new cases?
Have you?
You always answer a question with question.
It depends. I like going around in circles sometimes.
We found something.
What?
It could tell us more about these bodies in the river.
If there are any.
I believe it'll help us.
Are you going to tell me, or do I have to guess?
If you've seen Mrs. Woods lately, she may help us identify this clue.
A clue?
A shoe.
A shoe?
We found one.
There are lots of shoes in the river.
Mrs. Woods must know her husband's shoe size. Now, if by some chance
I've seen her.
What?
Mrs. Woods, I don't know where she is now, but somebody moved her and her children to another apartment. They also pay for her to lie low and shut up.
You could have called me if you'd known you were going to see her.
She's being watched. I don't know where she is. That's why I have to wait for her to contact me.
Great. Just great, Anna. Now you're obstructing justice. Now, what are the laws?
She's my client.
I don't give a damn. This is a police case. I have a right to be apprised. Now, I could have had her fired.
Oh, great. Then they'd assume your man, that had placed her and her children in danger. Would you do that to Robin and me?
Who are you? All right. When's the next contact?
I don't know.
This gets better. So the first contact possibly turns out to be the last.
You look exhausted.
I am.
I thought you'd be on a high after the way the meeting went.
Well, you know, the adrenaline is just starting to go now.
You really got to them.
Yeah, I really hope so. It means a better life for them. No more fear. No more violence.
They understand.
They can make as much money if they do things our way as they do now. Only then they won't have to worry about where the money comes from.
I'm telling you, they got the message.
And each and every one of them can start to live a decent life.
Is that what you want for yourself?
With my wife and with my daughter, yeah.
What about power?
What about it?
Think of all the control you have right now. It's intoxicating, isn't it?
Yes.
Admit you enjoy it.
Yes, I enjoy it, but not at the expense of my family.
Today was only the beginning.
I know that.
We have a long, long way to go. Branches of the organization are still into drugs, prostitution, loan sharking, numbers. It goes on and on. It isn't going to be easy. And it's going to take a lot of time and effort.
Julian was determined to change things. I'm just as determined.
You can do it.
Cheryl Stansbury, please. Alan Quartermain calling.
Really? No, that's fine. No, I don't want to leave a message. Thanks very much. She's on her way over here.
You know, that's another thing I like about her. She seems psychic.
Why do you suppose she'd come over here without calling first?
Well, she has some good news for us that she wants to deliver in person.
Or it could be bad news.
No, that we'd get by phone.
The lady has arrived. At least I hope she has. Jennings, it's all right. I'll get it.
Hi, Dad.
Hi, A.J.
Dad, I need to speak to you.
I can't do it now, son. I've got a meeting.
But it's really important.
I know, my dear. I'll talk to you later. Later. Promise.
Yeah, okay.
Hello, Cheryl. Please, come on in.
No, thank you. I'm sorry I didn't call first.
No, no need to explain. Take your coat. Oh,
thank you.
You look gorgeous.
Oh, thank you. You look very handsome yourself.
Thanks.
I wanted to talk to you and your father.
Well, I've got the day off, so I'm available. My father's here in the living room.
Oh, good.
Well, Cheryl, it's nice of you to come by. Can I offer you a drink?
No, no, thank you.
Coffee, tea?
No, nothing.
How about a pastry?
No.
Father, she didn't come here for milk and cookies.
Well, you sit down. You take that chair. It's my favorite.
Thank you.
So tell me, Cheryl, how are our investments doing?
Skyrocketing, I'll bet, if she has anything to do with it.
Well, as a matter of fact, the Stansbury Fund is doing beautifully.
Now, what did I tell you? Taking off like a skyrocket, huh?
Really on the rise, is it?
Yes, it is.
Uh-huh. Any particular reason?
Well, it's her unerring ability to sense an investment opportunity and to cash in on it.
Well, thank you. But actually, there is a reason why the funds are doing so well.
What is that?
Meditech.
Really?
Well, that's interesting.
Yes, and as a matter of fact, it's rising so fast, I thought you gentlemen might be interested in selling your fund and investing in straight stock.
Now, if it's appreciating, why would we want to sell?
Well, to make a killing. Isn't that it, Cheryl?
Yes.
Well, what do you think, Father?
Well, I feel good about Meditech and the fund.
So we hang on to it?
Well, yeah. We'll ride it to the crest and then cash in on it.
So Meditech's been driving up the fund's value, huh?
Well, that's what she just said, Alan. Don't you pay any attention?
Yes, I do. But when I'm making money, I like to be reassured.
Then I will assure you, Meditech is your best investment.
Excuse me, Dad, but I really
AJ,
need to speak to you.
AJ, please, I've already told you I have a meeting. I'll talk to you later.
Okay. I'm sorry.
Okay.
Do you see any more surefire investments on the horizon?
None better than you have.
I'll take your word for it.
Well, her word's as good as gold.
Well, thank you. I try. And thank you for your time.
Our time is your time.
That's right. Anytime you want to talk, just drop over. The door's always open.
And the welcome mat is out.
Well, you're both more than kind. And are you sure you don't want to sell?
Oh, I've never been more certain.
Okay. Well, thanks for seeing me.
My pleasure.
Oh, I can see myself out.
Anytime you're in the neighborhood, drop in.
Thank you. Bye for now.
Bye-bye.
That girl is a financial genius.
She's certainly done right by us.
Yeah, she certainly has. And I think Scotty may be right about asking Meditech to help out the hospital. Get the picture, Alan. If Meditech helps out the hospital, that doesn't hurt us one little bit.
She hasn't come back yet? All right, listen, would you tell her to call me at General Hospital? I'll be in the boardroom. Great, thank you very much. Oh, just who I was looking for.
Okay, you found me. Excuse me.
No, I want you to come into my office.
The boardroom?
Yes.
What was that for?
Oh, just being the prettiest, sexiest girl in town.
Oh, yeah? Me and 40 others, huh?
No, just you.
Then you want to marry me?
Marry? You're already married.
Technically.
Well, Bobby, I will be happy to help with your divorce, but it's going to take some time. In the meanwhile, we're having a good time now. Let's just keep it that way.
Think so, huh?
I think so, and I think you think so, too.
Saved by the bell.
Just for now. Don't go away. Hello?
It's Cheryl. I just had a meeting with Edward and Alan Quartermain.
How'd it go?
Perfect.
Great. I'll talk to you later then. Goodbye. We're having dinner tonight, right?